but man, they like to roll the dice. By chance they came upon a devil's game, and gosh, they paid the price. Paid the price.
Hello, and welcome to another episode of Masterworks of Video Game Music. I'm your host, Professor Lesser, and when I first heard of the 2017 game Cuphead, developed by Studio MDHR, I was immediately captivated by its unique look and style, considering that it had been designed to look like a 1930s cartoon. I had never seen anything like it, and judging from the game's success, neither had a lot of other gamers.
Cuphead began as the brainchild between brothers Chad and Jared Moldenhauer, who dedicated 4 years of their lives, quit their jobs, and even remortgaged their houses to make the game a reality. Growing up in Saskatchewan, Canada, the boys would frequently play video games in their basement, dreaming of one day being able to create their own. One of their closest friends playing along with them was Kristofer Maddigan, who would later grow up to write the original soundtrack for Cuphead. Maddigan began his musical training by learning piano, but quickly changed to drums and orchestral percussion, eventually becoming the principal percussionist of the National Ballet Orchestra in Toronto. Having known the Moldenhauers since the fifth grade, Maddigan was approached by Chad and Jared about writing the music for Cuphead. Since Cuphead would be designed around the concept of a 1930s-era cartoon, they wanted the music to fit the time period. The predominant style of music at that time was jazz, particularly the substyles of ragtime, swing, and big band music. Maddigan had no prior experience writing music for jazz bands, so he initially declined the offer. But after the Moldenhauers continued to ask him, he eventually relented and agreed. Maddigan himself attributes this to his belief that he was the only musician the Moldenhauers actually knew personally. Because this was Madigan's first time writing not only jazz music, but music for a video game, he spent time researching artists and musicians of the time. This not only involved listening to hundreds of jazz tunes, but also studying many jazz charts and reading books in jazz arranging. The barbershop quartet sections, heard of the game's introduction and in the second Inkwell Isle World, were inspired by materials collected by the Society for Preservation and Encouragement of Barbershop Quartet Singing in America, or SPEBSQSA for short. This organization really exists. Look it up. In addition, Maddigan also received guidance from Canadian jazz arranger John Herberman, who also conducted the 13-piece jazz band heard on the recordings. Maddigan would frequently send Herberman drafts of the music for him to look over and critique, giving Maddigan suggestions to improve and refine his technique. Maddigan wanted to write for Cuphead with the idea that the golden age of jazz and the golden age of video games coexisted within the same time period. For that, Maddigan turned to the great jazz artists of the first half of the 1900s to help inspire what would eventually become a modern masterpiece. Many of these early jazz artists were suggested by the Moldenhauer brothers, who even based some of their animations on their likenesses. The most obvious of these is the character of King Dice, who is based on the jazz conductor and singer Cab Calloway. Calloway's vocals and stage presence was not only the inspiration for King Dice, but his musical style, particularly the song Minnie the Moocher, would find its way into the game as King Dice's theme song.
I'm the devil's right-hand man. I can't let you pass, 'cause you ain't done everything. Bring me those contracts, come on, bring them to the king.
Hey folks, here's a story about Minnie the Moocher. She was a low-down hoochie-coocher. She was the roughest, toughest frail. Minnie had a heart as big as a whale.
The King Dice boss battles theme was also inspired by the tune Sing Sing Sing, recorded by clarinetist Benny Goodman with Gene Krupa on the drums.
Hey,
Benny Goodman's music with Gene Krupa and Lionel Hampton on the vibraphone also influenced the track Threatening Zeppelin. In addition, the dance troupe Whitey's Lindy Hoppers in the 1941 film Hell's a Poppin' led to the track Marine Corps. Great jazz pianist and composer Duke Ellington also contributed to the Cuphead soundtrack. His piece Caravan influenced Madigan's favorite track, Pyramid Peril. For the track Dramatic Fanatic, Maddigan included Canadian tap dancer Alison Toffant. This idea was inspired by the Nicholas Brothers, who frequently performed with Cab Calloway and his band. The earlier jazz style of ragtime was also a major part of the Cuphead soundtrack. The music of composers Scott Joplin, such as Maple Leaf Rag and The Entertainer, formed the foundation for the overworld Inkwell Isle theme. Cuphead's gameplay is divided by platforming sections known as run and gun and boss battles. Boss battles take up the majority of the stages, with each boss character having its own unique personality and style. Originally, the game was supposed to be much smaller, with an average of 8 to 10 bosses and around 20 music tracks. Soon after the Moldenhauers began designing the game, the list of tracks quickly expanded to nearly 50, forcing the game to be delayed until its eventual release on September 29, 2017. One of the most interesting features of Cuphead's music is that Maddigan wrote full-length jazz tunes as opposed to shorter musical phrases that could be looped together over and over. The technique of looping tracks is very traditional in video games due to the limited capability of the game's memory to handle full-length songs for the game's duration. In jazz music, improvisation is the ability for the player to create original melodies over a sequence of chords, essentially making it up as they go along. This is actually much more complicated than it sounds and takes years to eventually master. The Cuphead soundtrack features many different instruments and improvisation sections, and each time a player returns to the same boss stage, a different instrument will be heard soloing. We'll be right back. Maddigan had said that there are approximately 6 different solo mixes for each track, making a total of approximately 200 different mixes for the entire game. Cuphead was immediately successful after its release, and soon became one of the highest awarded games of that year. Kristofer Maddigan was also honored with a Canadian Juno Award in 2018 for Instrumental Album of the Year, and the Cuphead soundtrack hit number 1 on the Billboard Jazz Charts.
Now, one thing I didn't mention is how hard this game is.
In my playthrough recording for this video, I died over 100 times.
Come on! Really? Come on! Seriously?
Because this channel is primarily about original video game music and not walkthroughs or strategies, I'm afraid I can't really help you. But hey, if I could beat the game, so can you. Even though my playthrough involved a lot of rage quitting and a few choice words that are inappropriate for this family-friendly channel. Speaking of which, please feel free to like, comment, and subscribe. Until next time, I'm Professor Lesser, and thanks for watching.